LangChain has many agents that you can use in data analysis. One of these is the SQL agent that helps you talk to your database. Today, we cover how to use the SQL agent. To show this, we'll build an app with the Streamlit tool. Here is app we'll build. This app will help us chat with the database. We write a question about the data. The agent will return an answer. Nice! We've seen the app we create. Let's go ahead and take a look at the topics we'll cover. First, we'll create a virtual environment and install the tools we'll use. Next, we'll initialize our app. To do this, we'll leverage Streamlit. After that, we'll initialize our database. This database stores information about employees in a company. Our database includes two tables. As you can see here, these are employee and department tables. The DepNode column is our primary key. This creates a one-to-many relationship between departments and employees. Next, we'll create a SQL agent. And then, we'll pass the agent to the model and database. Lastly, we'll build our app. Using this app, you will be able to ask any question to your database. Awesome! We've seen the topics we'll handle. Let's dive in. To write our code, we're gonna use the VS Code editor. First, let's create a virtual environment. To do this, we're gonna use conda. Let's write conda create dash n. Let's name gen AI. I already created this. After that, we're gonna activate this environment. Conda activate gen AI. Here you go. Our environment is ready to use. The next step we're gonna do is install the tools we'll use. To do this, let's create the requirements.txt file. We're gonna click on the new file and then name it requirements.txt. After that, let's write the libraries we'll use here. First, let's type langchain. After that, let's type langchain community. This tool help us create the agent. And then, let's type langchain OpenAI. Langchain OpenAI. To build the app, we'll use Streamlit. Lastly, let's type python.env to get the environment variables. For now, these tools are enough to build the app. We're gonna now install this. It's simple to do this with pip. Let's write pip install -r requirements.txt. Here you go. Our tools are ready to use. To write our code, we're gonna create a Python file. Let me click on the new file and then give a name app.py. Yeah, our file is ready. So far, we created a virtual environment. Let's go ahead and set the environment variables. To do this, we're gonna use the .env tool. First, let's create an env file. Let me click on the new file and then name .env. Okay, our file is ready. Here, we're gonna type our environment variables. First, let's set the OpenAI API key. OpenAI API key. Let me paste the OpenAI API key. Next, let's set the LangChain API key. LangChain API key. This key helps us trace the outputs. You can get a LangChain API key for free from the LangChain website. Let's pass the API key. After that, to tell LangChain to log traces, let's set the LangChain tracing to true. LangChain tracing v2 equals true. Lastly, let's set the LangChain project name. LangChain project. Let's say data analysis agents. This will automatically create the project for you if it doesn't exist. Awesome! The environment variables are ready. All we need to do now is load these variables with .env. First, let's import the load.env method from .env import load.env. Next, let's use this method. Load.env. That's it. Variables are ready. It's simple, right? What we're gonna do now is initialize the app. To do this, we're gonna use Streamlit. First, let's import Streamlit. Import Streamlit as st. Next, let's set the page title. st.setPageConfig. Let's set page title. Let's pass talk to your database. Okay, after that, let's give the app a title. st.header. Let's pass talk to your database. What we're gonna do now is initialize the app. To do this, let's open the terminal and then write streamlit run app.py. The app automatically opens in your browser. There you go. You can see the title here. Let's go ahead and initialize our database. To do this, let's the SQL database class. First, let's import this class from Langchain community utilities SQL database import SQL database. Next, let's instantiate an object from this class. Let's say db equals SQL database. Let's call from URI. Let's pass the database SQLite. Let's give our database my demo.db. Great! Our database is ready to use. What we're gonna do now is create the SQL agent. First, let's get the chat model from OpenAI. To do this, let's import the chat OpenAI class from LangChain OpenAI import chat OpenAI. Next, let's initialize the chat model. Let's say LLM equals chat OpenAI. Let's set the temperature parameter. Let's give 0. We are ready to create the SQL agent. To do this, we're gonna leverage the create SQL agent method. Let's import this method from LangChain community agent toolkits import create SQL agent. Now, let's initialize our agent. Let's say agent executor equals, let's call the create SQL agent. Now, we're gonna give our model and database to this method. Let's write LLMs and then db equals db. Let's set the agent type. Agent type equals OpenAI tools. Let's set the verbose. Verbose equals true. Nice! Our agent is ready to use. Now, let's create a widget to get input from the user. To do this, we're gonna leverage the text input method. Let's say user question equals st. Let's call text input. Let's write a text. Ask a question about your database. Okay? Great! The input field is ready. Now, let's write the code to return the response. If user question is not none and user question is not empty, we wanna display a message while running a block of code. To do this, we're gonna use the spinner method. With st, let's call spinner. Let's pass text equals in progress. Next, let's return the response. To do this, let's write response equals, let's call our agent executor. Let's call the invoke method. Let's pass user question. Lastly, let's write the output in the response. st.write. Let's pass response. Let's select output. Awesome! Our app is ready to use. To see this app, let's go to our browser. We got an error. We wrote OpenAI tools wrongly. Let me fix this. Not underscore. Let me set dash. After that, let's go to our browser. There you go. Now, let's enter a question. Let's say, how many rows are there in the imp table? Let me press enter. Our agent started running. Here you can see how to think of our agent in the terminal. The agent is thinking step by step to find the result. Voila! Here is the response. Remember, our database includes two tables. Now, let's ask for information about the people who work in New York. Let's write, tell me about the people working in New York. Let me press enter. Our agent started running. Our agent gave us information about people working in New York. We can also ask for more specific information. Let's say, who works in New York? Let me press enter. Here you go. Employees who work in New York are Clark, King, and Miller. Let me check out. Let me select empt and then let's write 10. There you go. Here are Clark, King, Miller. Our app works very well. Let's go ahead and ask another question. What is the average salary of employees in Chicago? Let me press enter. Our agent took action. There you go. Here, you can see the average salary of employees in Chicago. You can ask any question you want about the database this way. To trace our agent, let's take a look at LangSmith. There you go. Here is our project. You can see information about the agent such as input, output, start time, latency, tokens, cost, etc. You can see the input and output for each query in detail. This way, you can monitor your agent. This is cool, right? Yeah, that's it. In this video, we covered how to talk to a database using the SQL agent. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and leave a comment. See you in the next video. Bye for now.